Hello everyone, welcome back. Today I have something really cool. Basically, an old friend of my brother's used to collect a lot of like Nintendo stuff or whatever. And this was years ago when we were like really young, like talking about like the 8-bit Nintendo days and whatnot. And yeah, he found a box that he had and he decided to give it to me of his old school games. And that was pretty cool because he always had like the cool games, you know, a long time ago. We had a handful of games and so forth, but yeah, whenever something new came out, yeah, he most likely picked it up. But yeah, there's just a handful of games that he gave me here, but I do have this little box, and I guess I'll show you what was in there. So I guess the first thing in this box was this guy here. And this here is a wireless controller set for the original 8-bit Nintendo. And it's battery operated. I was reading on the back, it takes 4 AAAs per controller. And I found that kind of weird. Yeah, it looks like this guy here, his batteries don't work too well, because if you notice right there, he's like getting kicked in the nuts right there, Hulk Hogan. But yeah. And this is what it looks like basically here. It has a receiver for both one and two players, and then of course you have buttons. There's triple fire buttons here on the top, and if you've seen like some of these newer Vem clones, I mean it's quite similar. I'm not really too sure if this has to be pointed directly to the receiver, but I'm thinking that it does. But yeah, the little old school picture there. Oh my gosh. Okay, so that's the first thing that was in there. There was also a little bag. I guess I'll show this next because this isn't anything too spectacular, but got a couple of things in here. What is this? Nintendo info file. I guess you could put like codes and stuff. Is that what that is? Your scores or something? Yeah. That's pretty weird. Mega Man 2, Mario 2, Link. And then just random stuff. I guess, you know, you keep your scores before how it is now with the online service. And then a couple of things. These are like those ones that you would find, you know, when you buy a game. These would generally be in the boxes, tell you, you know, little secrets and so forth. And to subscribe. Oh. Yeah, just a handful of flyers here. Let's see. What the heck is this one? Looks like Star Wars stuff on there. I guess this came with a Star Wars game or whatnot. A couple of other ones. This one is from Capcom. It has codename Viper. Kind of sort of like Rolling Thunder. Oh yeah, I remember this now. This here came with, yeah, if you did buy Capcom games. You guys probably remember that picture from a while back. Turbo Graphics colors there with the neon colors and what. But yeah, yeah, Bionic Commando, Mickey Mouse, Strider, and so forth. Wow, that is really old. I remember all that. And then quite similar, one for Acclaim. And then there's an Arc on there. I don't know. I mean, Acclaim was okay, but I think they were overrated back in the day. One for... Oh, that's Star Fox. That's pretty cool. But yeah. And it looks like we have a booklet for Pro AM. And another thing that comes out for ActRaiser. Oh, wow. Yeah. Let's bring that out a little bit so you guys can see that. Obviously, that was not an overseas picture. But yeah, so there you go. That's what was in this little box here. But yeah, this is just the tiny stuff that was in that box. I'll show you this next. This can hold, I want to say, 15 games. Because back then, you really weren't going to have a whole ton of games if you were a kid trying to get 8-bit Nintendo. But here we have Isolated Warrior, which is a diagonal type of game. Sort of like Viewpoint, I guess you could say. But yeah, you control this guy and he does like backflips. It's actually pretty cool. Pretty cool game to play, two player versus, this is spy versus spy. Oh, that's good. I was about to pick this up, but yeah, Street Fighter 2010. With the booklet. This is a really cool game too, the Immortal. I like this one better than the Sega Genesis one. And then here we have Low G Man. This is a pretty cool game as well. And last but not least, one other title. RoboCop. Drop it. You know, it's funny because he picks up like battery packs to get his life back, but it should have been baby food. Okay, so we got that there. And oh yeah, that stuff is pretty cool. So we'll play all that to the side. And then I actually have a handful of games. Well, I just put this away over here. Make a little bit room so you guys can see these a little bit better. But there was a handful of games that were in the box. They said in the box. So we'll start off. There was Super Nintendo and 8-bit Nintendo games. And yeah, this one here is a classic. Right here. Yeah. That's crazy because I mean this thing looks like it's brand new, the box and everything. But yeah, for the NES, that's a cleaning system there. Konami game, Mad City, BioBilly. Yeah. Oh my gosh, look at his face. The way they drew it and everything is like okay. But yeah, this is a really cool game. If you like beat 'em ups, this is one of the cooler ones for the 8-bit Nintendo. It's crazy because when we lived overseas, the two games that we actually had that were official were Mad City and Ninja Ryukenden. Everything else, we didn't know at the time because we were little, but yeah, they were bootleg. Here we have Heroes of the Lance, Dungeons and Dragons. And these games are always quite interesting. I have one for the TurboGrafx. It's called Order of the Griffin. And it's kind of weird because when you attack and in the middle of the battle, the music just like stops. Oh, here we go. Wrath of the Black Manta. We actually played this all the way through. You save like kids, and I don't know, the artwork is kind of goofy on this one. But, you know, it was a ninja game, so yeah. You're the ultimate force of one, like Army of One right there. And this guy here, Magician. This is a really cool game. If you ever play Solstice, I want to say. Oh no, this is a whole different game. I got this mixed up with Solstice, but yeah, this is actually pretty cool. For the 8-bit Nintendo, I mean, there was a whole lot of games that played like this, so it's worth trying out. It's an adventure game. It's only side view, but it has some variety. Sort of like an RPG, but not quite. And Deity East game here, Cobra Command. Man. Yeah, I mean, these things are like totally old school. I mean, I remember them, and it's cool to see them in the box and everything, you know, still intact. And here we go. Narc. Yeah, if you ever played this in the arcade, this had like some pretty cool graphics for back in the day. It's also on the Midway Classics, Midway Treasures Volume 2. The actual arcade version. This was a really cool game too, but man, yeah. I played this one first, and then after seeing the arcade version, I'm like, oh my goodness. You know, it's very colorful, good high-res graphics for the time. Yeah, so those would be the 8-bit Nintendo games. So that's pretty cool. And then on top of that, there was also a handful of Super Nintendo games. And as you know, Super Nintendo games, these days, people want crazy money if they're in boxes. But, yeah. Got here, Ken Griffey Jr. Winning Run. Yeah, I transferred all the Super Nintendo games to the Super UFO. So, yeah, you know, I take them out of the box and then put them back in the box, basically. Here, Wings Aces High. Part 2, I guess, or that's Wing Square. Made by Namco. But it uses Mode 7. It's kind of a weird game, but yeah. You know, back when the Super Nintendo was new, that Mode 7 was definitely state-of-the-art there. You know, people were like blown away, and the Genesis, you know, just couldn't do it. This is pretty cool. Williams Arcade Greatest Hits. And this has the older games from Midway. I wasn't a big fan of these games like during this time frame. When they started pulling out like Total Carnage and stuff, that was like, that's the ones that I really liked. Smash TV, what else? Mortal Kombat 2, I like that one. That was actually a really cool game. This was actually an arcade game that you could sit down on. Ported, of course, to the Super Nintendo, Steel Talons. Of course, it wasn't exactly as good as the arcade version. It didn't have that same feel, I guess, but yeah. That's pretty cool. Let's see. A couple of other games here. George Foreman's KO Boxing. And, this one is okay. There was another game, Foreman for Real. That one is really cool. Definitely check out Foreman for Real. It has like digitized graphics of George Foreman and some other people. Here we have Jurassic Park Motion. It says that you can also use the mouse on this one. I've never known that you could use the mouse, but I remember this being really popular when it came out, especially since the movie was big. That's one of the games that when they brought out a movie to game, movie to game release, it actually came out pretty good. Okay, a couple of other titles here. Actually, quite a few here. Here we have Battleship. Now, you could play this like in campaign mode, but I think there's also the original mode here. But yeah, not too shabby. If you ever played Motor Tune Grand Prix 2, or actually, it's called Grand Prix here in the US, but there's a game similar to this. It plays like the original version. Let's see here. Primal Rage. Of course, that was an arcade game. And save $4 at Six Flags with inside coupon. That's kind of strange that they would have that there. But I guess maybe was it related to Time Warner? Because it says Time Warner on the bottom there. I don't recall if Six Flags is Time Warner. Let's see. I'll show you this one next, and this is Warp Speed by Ballistics. These guys actually brought out Double Dragon to the Sega Genesis. This game is okay. It's a little bit different from most spaceship games, I guess you could say. It's kind of like, what's that game? It's not called Starfighter, I forget the name of it, but Questmere. I'll just throw that up there. Here we have Super R-Type, and this game is based off of the second game that came out in the arcade, but, kind of revamped, I want to say. There's a couple of things that were changed on this one, maybe because of the hardware limitations, or maybe they just want to change it up, but really cool. This one came out, and there was also R-Type 3. Those were the two that came out for the Super Nintendo. If you want to play the first one, they have it for the Master System, but the best one's on the TurboGrafx. Okay, so we're down to the last three here. And everybody knows this one if you played Super Nintendo. This is a big deal because this was the first 16-meg cartridge for the Super Nintendo. And this was a really big deal because it was exclusive to the Super Nintendo. That there was a big hit on Sega. Sega tried to fight back by putting a rating system where they could put like mature games and so forth. But this here, I mean, when Street Fighter was announced exclusively for the Super Nintendo, Super Famicom, people were like all about the Super Nintendo. It wasn't arcade perfect, as they said, but this was a really good port for the time. I remember it was a summertime before this was actually released. Nintendo came to one of the bases that we were at, and I was, we were like younger back then, and they had the Nintendo trailer. Like, it was there for the whole summer, and you could play, those competition carts where it had like F-Zero and what is that, Pilot Wings, and there was a couple other games, and you had to time them in. It was crazy because, I mean, you could literally play in the competition And if you didn't win, you'd just line back up and play again, because, I mean, the line wasn't long. And then they also had a showcase, like, in an air-conditioned trailer, a whole bunch of Super Nintendo games like Ninja Turtles, R-Type, and so forth. But they had this one there, and I remember nobody was playing in the arcades at our BX. Everybody was here just playing this for free. It was a Japanese version, but, yeah. I mean, this was a big draw to that Nintendo trailer, whatever you want to call it. It was cool that they just hung out there all summer. I mean, they just turned on the power switch and, you know, you just walked over there and played the games. Yeah, I know that was a long story, but oh well. And then the next one here we have, this is Darius Twin. I was going to say Sagaya, but yeah, this is a two-player date, Darius game. Darius games are kind of weird to me. I mean, I like fish and all that and, you know, sea creatures, but yeah, I don't know. It's a cool game, don't get me wrong, but yeah, I didn't like them until they started getting on the Sega Saturn and so forth. And then, I guess the crowning jewel on all these guys here, man, this is at 16 minutes, but I know it's quite a few things, but would be this guy here. And this is Space Megaforce, and these are the same guys who did Blazing Lasers. This is really, really cool to find this, you know, have this complete inbox, because, yeah, it plays a lot like Blazing Lasers. I don't know, by comparison, I'd like Blazing Lasers better, but, you know, this is like the Super Nintendo equivalent. It almost sounds like the sound effects were just like almost digitized from the TurboGrafx version and placed on here. That's how it sounds like to me, but a really uncommon game, that's for sure. If you're into shooters and you're a Super Nintendo collector, you probably are familiar with this game here, but yeah, definitely worth checking out. But yeah, like I said, I put all these on the Super UFO, so now they're gonna just stay in the boxes, I guess. I have a handful of other games that are boxed, and yeah, it's just cool to get these, you know, get the hookup on these guys, especially, you know, since some of them are really cool titles. Yeah, there would be the little collection box there. I think that this was just all that was left. He had like a whole ton of games like a long, long time ago, but yeah, definitely cool, especially, like I said again, for the Space Megaforce. But yeah, again, as always, thanks again for watching. This is Agent Zero for Yakuza Games, and I'll talk to you guys next time.